Harry Kane's preferred destination, reportedly City. We spoke about this yesterday, Goffey. Lots of papers picking up on this. He wants to play for Pep Guardiola. Back of the Sun, it says an exclusive, $80 million for Kane, and that's just his wages. City United in mega offer. We know the price tag is $150 million. That's what Daniel Levy reportedly would like for him. $80 million in wages is not bad, is it? When you heard about this story, when it broke, did it surprise you at all? Are you expecting this?
No, I don't want it to be true. Obviously, I have a little bit of soft spot for Tottenham. I'd like, and I think all Tottenham fans obviously understand that Tottenham are not pushing for major honours. I mean, when the Ryan Mason, who's in charge at this moment in time, comes out and said the 5 years behind Manchester City, I mean, what a kick in the teeth that must have been for Harry Kane. I know they're good friends, but the last thing you want, they've just sacked Mourinho, one of the most high-profile managers in the world, and they say they're 5 years behind Manchester City. So if you're Harry Kane and you listen to that, you're probably thinking, perhaps this isn't the club for me to be at if I want to win a trophy, if we're 5 years behind them. So to go to Manchester City, I totally get it. He knows he's guaranteed to win something, without a doubt, and he finished his career having won something. Mm. Pochettino won a trophy his first game away, didn't he, from Tottenham? First game in charge, they won a cup. So, there you go.
What do you think in terms of Harry Kane and his potential suitors? Because Chelsea are interested, apparently, both Manchester clubs. Daniel Levy obviously is not going to want to sell to a rival, but if Harry Kane wants to stay in the Premier League and he can push for this and the price tag gets matched, is there much else that can happen?
Well, the only club I don't think he'd want him to go to, the fans would be Chelsea. Absolutely gutted if he went to Chelsea. I mean, come on, that would be a proper kick, wouldn't it? But I get the Manchester City thing. I mean, with Pep Guardiola, he is the best manager in the world in a lot of people's eyes. I still prefer Klopp, but a lot of people would say Pep Guardiola is the best manager, and I'm not there to argue that point.
Why do you prefer Klopp?
Always have. I just think Klopp's always gone to the club that's not the best and made them the best. Pep's always been at the best, whether it be Barca, Bayern or Man City. So I just think Klopp, for me, has gone to clubs that are further down the table and he's turned them into title winners. Their clubs, Tottenham, Daniel Levy, the fans are not going to let him go. It's just not going to happen, the Chelsea one. But I can see him going to Manchester City. I think that's the one. You look at Manchester United last night, you saw that goal from Cavani. Mm. How good was that, by the way?
So good.
I'm not sure about the assist. He didn't touch that, did he?
He didn't touch it at all.
He didn't touch it. No. I mean, if he'd have touched it, it'd have gone straight into the defender. But he missed it and he gets an assist for that.
Let's not let that ruin a beautiful goal.
Yeah. But what a finish.
Don't worry about it.
But what a finish. And so when it comes to Manchester United, I'm sure Manchester United fans would love Harry Kane as well. Mm. They have got Cavani, they've got Greenwood, they've got Rashford, can all play there. But I think Manchester City is the obvious one if he were to stay in England.
Goffey, if he goes to Manchester City, how much of the league is just going to be a walkover for City? Like, realistically, what is everyone else going to do?
Yeah, exactly.
Not my team, because we're just fighting to, I don't know, finish 10th. Like, but other teams that, you know, we were kind of excited about the fact that Liverpool, when they've got everyone back next season, Chelsea as well, feeling like they're going to challenge against a City side that haven't strengthened yet. So that in itself was going to be, oh, this is going to be an amazing season. If Harry Kane goes to City, might as well all just stop working.
Well, it would be very difficult, wouldn't it? I mean, for Liverpool to come back from that, for Manchester United, you've got a guy who's an absolute genius. And somebody came on yesterday and we're talking about, oh, Harry Kane, it's the right time to sell. We'll never get this much money for him if we leave it. I mean, you've just got to remember, this guy just puts in goals for fun. Even with injuries, he scores over 25 goals in a season. So if he goes to Manchester City, with what they create, you imagine what could happen and the goals he could score. It could be like Lewandowski at Bayern Munich, where he's just popping in goals for fun, because they're going to create for him, aren't they? And he's a natural finisher. And this year, the way Mourinho, all the stick Mourinho has got at Tottenham, remember when he signed on the documentary, he said, I'm going to make you, you're here at the minute, below Lewandowski and all them guys, Messi, Ronaldo, I'm going to take you there. And if you look at his performances this year, all round, not just goal scoring, coming deeper, assists. Look at the assists he's made. Look at the goal. He's top of both sets of stats, if you want to go on stats. He's an amazing footballer. And with Pep, The one thing about him, he spends loads of money. There's no doubt about that. You can't argue that. If you're a Manchester City fan, I know you won't say, oh, the clubs have spent money as well. But he has spent so much money. But he never goes out, really, and spends 150 million on one. I think the highest he's paid, what is it, was 60-odd for Diaz, right? Yeah. That's the highest he's paid, right? So to go out and suddenly spend 150 million... That's not like Pep.
Yeah, it'll be a lot. You're right. The 60 millions kind of come in groups, don't they? They might just grab three players at 60 million each. They'll be amazing or whatever. But if he did break the bank for Harry Kane, I think it'd be game over for everyone else.
TalkSport Breakfast with Laura Woods. Monday to Wednesday mornings, 6 till 10. On AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.